गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 4 ऑन डिजिटल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स. इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट नॉट गेट एंड हाउ टू इंप्लीमेंट दिस नॉट गेट बाय यूजिंग स्विचिंग सर्किट एंड देयर आफ्टर वी सी हाउ वी इंप्लीमेंट द नॉट गेट बाय यूजिंग योर ट्रांजिस्टर. देन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट योर एंड गेट एंड वी हैव ड्रॉन द ट्रुथ टेबल फॉर एंड गेट. सो लेट मी रिवाइज वन सेकेंड. The symbol for your AND gate is AND gate. Minimum input for AND gate is 2. I said the minimum input. It can have more than 2 input also. So this is the circuit symbol for your AND gate. Here the output is equal to A dot D. Here the this dot represents AND operation. Then what is the truth table for AND gate? So we have two inputs, hence we have 2 to the power 2. That means 4 combination of input. 0 0 0 1 1 0 and 1. So in case of AND gate, when both the inputs are high, here in digital high means logic 1, low means logic 0. When both the inputs are high in case of AND gate, then only the output will be high. Other case the output will be 0. That means if both the inputs are low or one of the inputs will be at low position, then the output will be low. So how next is how to implement this AND logic by using switching circuits. So here we have how to implement it by using switching circuits. Here I am drawing the switching logic for AND gate. So here we have two inputs, hence we need two switch A and B. Here the load is your bulb. The bulb will glow only when the current reaches its current passing through it. We are applying supply voltage, suppose 5 volt. This is A and this switch is B. See, the current only flow in this case, the both the switch are in series and that is also series with your bulb as well as your source. The current flow through this path only when both the switch are on. Switch on means in digital, that is logic 1. Switch on means in digital logic 1. Suppose A is equal to 1, B is equal to 0. That means this switch is on, B is equal to 0 means this switch is off. Then also there is no current flow because here the circuit is open. Hence no current flowing through this bulb. Hence the bulb will be at off condition. Okay. When both the switch are on, that means A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1. Then only the current will flow through this path and also reaches at the bulb, hence the bulb will glow and that condition is y equal to 1. So in this way we can implement the AND gate by using switching logic. So next is this is your digital electronics subject. That means you need to implement this switch by using a electronic switch. So the electronic switch can be made up of diode or transistor. In the last class we have discussed how to implement a NOT gate by using transistor. In this case we can also implement the AND gate by using transistor, but I am going to explain it by using by taking diode. So you all have studied about diode in your basic electronics. So let us talk about this diode. Diode is a PN junction just I am going to discuss it briefly. It is a two terminal unidirectional device. Why it is a unidirectional device? Because the current conduction takes place only in one direction, and in other direction huge impedance offered by the circuit, offered by the device. So it's a two terminal device, hence this terminal is known as anode and this terminal is known as cathode. I'm generally it K. When this diode is on, that is forward bias, when this, suppose this is a silicon diode, so minimum 0.7 volt is required to on the silicon diode. Hence if you apply, suppose this voltage is VA and this voltage is VK, hence if I apply KVL, VA means with respect to this only potential always measured with respect to your ground. So this is your ground, and again this is your also ground, hence this node potential is VA. You study about this in network theory or circuit theory. So by applying KVL, this is positive negative, so by applying KVL, VA minus 0.7 minus VK is equal to 0, hence VA minus VK is equal to 0.7 volt, or VA is equal to 0.7 plus VK. So what we can inference or observe from this equation, that means the potential at the anode, the potential at the anode, the voltage at the anode must be greater than equal to 0.7 volt than the potential at cathode. For example, if this potential is 3 volt and this potential is 2.3 volt, then only this diode will be on. So minimum just the diode will be on or conducting only when the anode potential is greater than the cathode potential. That is minimum 0.7 volt in case of silicon diode, or in case of germanium diode, this potential will be 0.3 volt. So now we are using this diode to implement AND logic. This is your AND gate. So this is the symbol for AND gate. The practical circuit I am going to implement it by using diode. So obviously two input, that means we need two switch. Here we can observe two switch. Suppose this is your bulb connected here. The bulb will be on. The bulb will be on when the 5 volt, minimum 5 volt is required to on this bulb. So there are 4 cases. You already have seen this A, B and Y. So first I am applying both the voltage A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 0. So for that case you can observe here this is 5 volt, and here the anode is, this is anode, this is cathode, in this case this is anode, this is cathode. Your anode is connected with 5 volt, and the cathode is connected to 0 potential. So obviously this diode is on. The moment this diode is on, so here both the diodes are on. That means in ideal diode you can replace the on condition by using short circuit. So obviously the potential is 0 means both the terminal are grounded. So obviously here you can see a short circuit path, that is Y is connected. Your Y is connected to ground through this A bar or B bar, hence the potential is 0. So obviously the ball will be at off condition. So when A is equal to 0, B 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. so the condition is we apply both the kernel as 0 and y is equal to 0. Then next case is see here, in this case, if I apply A equal to 0 and B is equal to 5 volt, that is 5 volt. Here 1 means 5 volt and 0 means ground or 0. So I am applying B. So obviously, the minimum voltage must be at the anode, must be 5.7 volt in order to on this circuit. Hence, what happened? But in this case, here the cathode is connected to zero potential, but anode is at high, that is your 5 volt. So obviously, in between A, in this case, A will be on and B will be off. Why will be off? Because here the cathode also connected to 5 volt potential. So this will be off. Off means we replace diode with open circuit. On means we replace diode with short circuit. So again, why will be connected to ground through this A terminal only? Why will be connected to ground this A terminal only? Similarly, in the third case, also why will be connected to ground with the B terminal only? So when both the inputs are high, the last case, when both the inputs are high, that means if I apply A equal to 5 volt and B is equal to 5 volt. In that case, obviously, the minimum potential required to on, minimum potential at this anode level must be 5.7 in order to on this diode. But we are supplying here 5 volt. Hence, both the diodes are off. Both the diodes are off. When you are applying A equal to 1, B equal to 1, both the diodes are off. Obviously, no current will flow through this path, and this 5 volt will be connected to this y. Y is equal to now 5 volt. Here the current will flow through this path only. Hence, this ball will be on. This is. So, in this way, we design an AND gate by using a switching logic or by using a diode. Next will be rule number 3. We have already discussed rule number 1, that is your complement. So, before I am going to rule number 3, here the observation in case of, I have already explained it to you, that is A dot 0 is always equal to 0, A dot A is always equal to A and A complement is equal to 0, A and 1 is always equal to A. So these 4 points you always need to remember it, because we are going to use it extensively while solving in algebra. So next logic will be your OR gate. This must be remember. A and which 0 will always get 0. A and A is equal to A. A complement A and another is the A complement always get 0. A and 1 is equal to A. I explained it in the last lecture. Now I am going to teach you about another logic, that is rule number 3 of Boolean algebra, that is OR gate. So first of all, we will see how we represent this OR gate. The symbol for this OR gate is, this is the symbol A and B. Here the output is Y. So this is the symbol for your OR gate. We have already studied the symbol about the complement gate, then buffer, then AND gate, and this is the symbol for your OR gate. Now obviously the minimum input applied to OR gate is 2. We can apply also more than 2 input as per the voltage levels. So now if you have 2 inputs, hence we have 4 possible combinations. The truth table for this OR gate is, so 4 possible combinations are 0 0 0 1 1 0 and 1 1. Hence this OR gate will be off or produce output 0 only when both the inputs are low. That means when both the inputs are 0, A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0, then only we get output is equal to 0. How we represent OR gate? OR gate is represented mathematically or Boolean algebra. That is, here plus is not A plus B, we are not adding. This is the logic operation, and this plus sign indicates OR operation. Either A or B or operation. So when both the inputs are, the OR gate output will be 0. The OR gate output will be 0 only when both the inputs are 0. Both the inputs are 0. When one of the inputs is at high, that means one of the input is 1, the output of the OR gate will be 1. So 0 1 that means 1, 1 0 1, and here 1 1 also going to be produced 1. So this is the truth table for your OR gate. So this is the truth table for your OR gate. Here you can observe that the output will be 0 only when both the inputs are 0. This is very very important. The output of the OR gate will be at low only when both the inputs are 0. Then how, next is how to implement this using switching circuits, and what are the conclusion we will draw from this OR gate. So conclusion is, the inference, suppose both the inputs are A, that means A plus A. In place of B, I just replacing, and both the inputs are, I am applying same input to this terminal and also this to this terminal. That means A or A. When A or A, you can see here, when both the inputs are same, that means when both are 0, output will be 0. When both are 1, output will be 1. Similarly, in this case, when both are A, output will be then observe here from the truth table only. I am drawing this conclusion. When both the inputs are same, output will be, suppose here inputs are 0 and 0, hence output will be 0. Here inputs are 1 and 1, hence output will be 1. So here the inputs are A and applying A to other terminal also, hence the output will be A. Next is A or 0. In this case, you can see here, if this will produce you also A plus 0 is always going to produce A. Why A? Here you can see, because when one of the input is 0 and other is 1, that will be 1. Hence it depends on, next is, here one of the input is 0, other is 1, this is also 1. Here one of the input is 0, other is 0, output will be 0. So obviously A with OR which 0 always going to be equal to A. A plus 1. This is very very important. We are going to use it extensively. A or 1. When the moment you see in OR gate, one of the input is 1, forget about the other input, the output will be 1 only. So that drastically reduces the number of variables. Obviously here A or 1, the output will be 1. The moment you see one of the input in case of OR gate is high, the output will be high. The next important is A plus A complement. That also always going to give you output will be 1. How A plus A complement is equal to 1. For example, so in order to prove this, I am taking example. So a equal to, for example, 0 a complement. 0 complement, you already studied. 0 complement is 1. So 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. So for example, if I take a is equal to 1 and a complement is equal to obviously 0, hence 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. So these two important rules you must remember. A or with 1, other equal to 1, and a or with complement of itself, that is a complement, always going to give you 1. So this is very very important, you must remember this. Once again, a or a always going to give you a or 0 always going to give you a plus 1 always going to give you 1 only, a plus a or a complement, that is going to give you 1. So for example, if in a circuit, in a logic, suppose you are given like this, y is equal to a b c plus a complement b c plus 1. So the moment you see that this is a OR operation, whatever may be the variable here it will be ORed with one of the input is 1. Hence, the output of this after simplification will get, the output will be 1. Y is equal to 1. Whatever may be the variable input, if one of the input is 1, OR gate always produce, the output will be 1. So, we no need to implement this by using circuits. Now, because here the output will be always 1. So, this is the very, very important. You must remember this concept. When one of the input is high, OR gate always produce 1. And when OR gate A or A complement, A OR gate with A complement, output will be always 1. So next is how to implement this by using switching circuits. Switching logic for OR operation. So in case of AND gate, you have taken two switch and your bulb has been connected in series with both the switch. In this case, you are going to implement OR gate by using two switch, because here we have two inputs, hence you need two switch. Now how these both the switches connected? This is connected in parallel. This is connected in parallel, and overall now it will be connected with series with your bulb. And both the switches are parallel, A and B are parallel, but they are connected with the bulb and the supply voltage 5 source is in series. So both are series to 5 volt and bulb, but they are parallel to each other. So when this bulb will on, when this bulb will be on, when obviously when both the switch are on or any one of the switches will be on, the current will follow that path. The current will flow through this switch only. So when this bulb will be off, that means output will be 0. Obviously in this case we can observe here both the switch are open, hence no current flowing through this part to reach at the bulb terminal, hence output will be 0. So for example, next case I am considering A is equal to 1, that means this switch is on, and B is equal to 0. So obviously this switch will be open, hence the current flow through, now this current will flow through this path and reach at the potential, reach at the bulb, hence Y equal to 1, that means bulb will glow. So similarly, when A is equal to 0, B is equal to 1, the current will flow this path and reach at the bulb. Now when both are on, in that case also the current will flow, and because both are short circuited, and current will flow through this path only and reach at the ball and y equal to 1. So remember, in case of OR gate, the output will be 0 only when both the switch are open. Only when both the switch are open. When both the switch are open, that means A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 0. At this time only, the output will be 0 and the ball will be off. So this is the switching logic. We'll see after studying about the NAND gate and OR gate, we'll see how to implement this OR gate also your AND gate by using transistor. So now rule number 4. This is also very very important rule. While you are studying this, all these rules of Boolean algebra, in order to minimize your number of gates or hardware, we need simplification. Otherwise, what will happen? The cost of the circuit as well as the complexity of the circuit will improve, will increase. So, the rule number 4 is your distributive law. You all have studied about from your mathematics. Distributive law, rule number 4. You all have heard about this distributive law. And this is very, very important. This law is very, very important with respect to your Boolean algebra. So, first, A dot B plus C. A dot, that means A and with B or C is always going to give you A and B or B and C. So this is your distributive law, where A and with B or C is always equal to A and B or B and C. Then the next, this is very important, A or B and C, A or B and C equal to, you have this AND, A or B dot A or C. So remember this, how we are using this A or B and C is equal to A or B and A or C. So from this you can also prove this. That is from RHS you can prove also. We can also get the LHS. So this is very very important. The second law, there is hardly any Boolean algebra. Each and every simplification we are going to use this concept A or B and C equal to, how we can represent this A or B and A or C. So from this, here just AND with here A and A or A and A or A and B, then so from this is your from the AND operation, just AND operation, just your multiplication like A and A or A and C, A and B and B and C. Then from your AND operation, A, both are both the inputs in case of AND gate. Here I am using that concept. Both the inputs are same. In case of AND gate, the output will be also that variable, that is A. Then A and C plus or A and B or B and C. Here you can take common A. So what will be remaining? 1 or C plus or A and B plus B and C. So I am putting this, that is your from RHS will find this LHS. Hence you can prove this, this should be wrong. Hence here you can see here C or with 1, C or with 1, that means the result will be 1 only. So A dot 1 plus A and B plus B and C. So here also you can take A and 1 in your AND operation. When one of the input is 1, another is by the variable will be as it is A or A and B, here B and C. So again you can take here A as a common, you can take here A as a common. I am doing this here. So what will be remaining? If you take A common, what will be remaining? 1 or B or B and C. So 1, if one of the input in case of OR gate, if one of the input is 1, then no need to see the other input, the output will be 1 only. So A and 1 plus BC. So we can prove this, that is here A and 1, that means this is A only. So we can prove this from, that is A or B and A or C always going to give you A plus BC. How this is very important? This is very important. Number of times they ask you to prove this distributive law, that is A or B, B and C equal to A or B and with A or C. So you can prove this, which also proved here. So note it down and practice it, because this is a 5-mark question. So why this law is very important? So first of all, now we are in a position to see this. Suppose we need to implement this by using a, suppose you need to implement this by using your logic gate. So how to implement this function and then this function and then finally that will be AND operation. So A or B, so for that now implement this using your logic circuit. So A or B, how it will be? So this is your A, this is your B, and finally this is your A or B. So for example, this is your X and this is your Y. So finally we need X and Y. So finally this is your X. Then how to implement A or C similarly? So I am taking here because this input is A. So one of the input of the second OR gate is A and another input is C. C. So finally this will produce A or C, which I am assuming Y. So finally both are 100, that is X and Y, that is X and Y. So how to implement this? We need a AND gate. So finally that will produce your X and Y. Your X is A or B and Y is A or C. So how many gates we need in order to implement this logic? We need 3 gates. But what is the benefit of this? You can see from here. Here, after simplification, that is after applying this distributive law, how many gates you need to implement this? So after simplification, that is your, this is your circuit. That means we need one logic to implement B and C, that is your AND gate. This is your B and C, and then you need one A, that is another variable here, and finally both you are applying, going to apply this to your OR gate. See here. Both represent the same function. Both represent the same function. But in order to implement this logic, we need how many number of gates? 1, 2, and 3 gates. But in order to implement the same function by after simplification, we need only 2 gates. So obviously, here we can see the hardware complexity as well as the cost of this logic will be more as compared to this logic. Hence, by using distributive law, we can able to reduce, we can able to simplify, we can be able to minimize the number of gates required to implement the logic. We can observe here. This is very important. From this, we can whatever we have studied in the definition of Boolean algebra, we can conclude from here only. Here in this case, we need 3 logic gates. Here we need 2 logic gates. Hence, we need simplification. But so whenever we see, so apply this distributive law carefully. That is my sincere advice to you. This is very very important. Most of the time you will find this question in any competitive examination as well as your semester examination. So whenever you see that in the bracket here, both the here A, here also A, when both the inputs are same, then from this you can directly write that is A or with this remaining whatever may be present. So first we write this both the term, that is A or V, B and C, whatever may be remaining here present. Here B D or C D, then the term will coming as B D and C D. So this is very very important. So you need to remember this. This is very very important just to clear there. So another question is here solve. That is your given as A or B, A complement plus C. So here what will be the output? So simply A, this is your another question. So A and with A complement plus A complement B, then AC or with BC. So from this we can conclude that this A or A complement that always gives you 0 plus A complement B plus AC plus your BC. So we will see this one of the theorem, that is your consensus theorem. Then I will solve this question. So if question number 1, if it is given that A plus A complement B, then if I apply here distributive law, then how by using this, how to write this? You can here write this as A or A complement equal to A or B. Just I'm applying this distributive law here. Here see, A is the only single term, hence in the bracket this A will be same, A will be same, and finally remaining. And so how to write this? By just apply this distributive law. Here A in place of B, just it is replaced by A complement. Hence, in place of B, I wrote it down here, that is A complement. Again, remaining is A, and here this is in place of C, this is here it is written as B, hence this is B. Just apply your distributive law, whatever you are studying. I am telling this will help you in order to simplify many number of logic gates. So A or with A complement B, that means A or I am applying your distributive law. Here I am applying your distributive law. So always how you are applying this, that means A or BC, always write it down. How prove this things right now, A or B and A or C. So just in case of B, here the question is A complement, here the question given is A complement, so A or A complement and with A or B. So from the all logic, I have already explained you that A or with A complement, that is a variable or with the variable itself, the complement of itself, then the output always is 1 and the remaining is A or B. So here this is 1 and with the remaining is A or B, so always with this, that will produce as A or B. So in this way, from A or with A complement B, so obviously you will need to first to complement the variable, then another gate is needed to find A complement and B, then finally we need another gate to represent OR operation. So from here the minimum gate required to implement this is 3, but in this case only 1. So how powerful this theorem is, we can observe here. So that's it. In the next class we will complete the rules of all